Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Michel. Today I have a friend here. This is Fabio Jacinto, he's a friend of mine. He's a fifth dan black belt degree in Hapkido, Korean martial art. Yeah. He uses the sai, this weapon, in his training, and today we will make a test. Because some people say that the sai may break katana, may break the Japanese sword. So today I will test my sword. This one is the Oniyuri from Chenes against his pair of sai. And please be careful and don't try this kind of test at your house, because you may hurt yourself, cut yourself, and eventually your blade may be damaged or may break, depending on the materials used on the blade of your sword. Okay, so let's do the tests.
Mais para ponto, muito bem por baixo, e aqui se faz a pressão. Pequena torção na lâmina, porém a lâmina não quebrou.
Isso é uma pequena marca aqui.
Uma pequena marca também.
Agora, a diferença é que a lâmina, o sai entrou pelas costas da espada. Vamos ver se vai causar alguma diferença na tela. Pode?
Então, ele dominou a minha espada, né? E vai tentar bloquear. Eu só preciso abandonar a minha katana e utilizar a minha wakizashi, né? Então, seria um ataque com a minha espada, devagar.
Então, né? Forte quanto assim.
Ele ia capturar a lâmina dessa forma, né? Dominando a espada, né? E em seguida tomando a espada do meu adversário, né? E realizando um corte.
Well, people, this video was made to verify this myth that the sai was able to break the Japanese sword. As you saw, the sai can't break the Japanese sword, the katana. It may bend the blade, but you need to apply a lot of force or impact in the blade. But as you can see here, I managed to fix the blade, just like fencers do with rapiers today, using the feet. You place the sword on the ground and place your feet over the blade and pull it, and it is enough to repair the bend in the blade of the sword. It had some blade damage also here on the cutting edge of the sword. I will need to repair the sword in the future. Probably I will make another video just about how to repair the sword that was exposed to this kind of damage. I don't know, maybe I will need to redo the heat treatment on this particular sword. This one is not heat treated like the real Nihonto, original sword made by sword makers in Japan. It has integral heat treatment, so I can normalize the steel, then heat treat it, and again, so it will make another very interesting video in the future. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the test that we made. If you want to know about the channel of Fabio Jacinto, the Saboninho of Hapkido, I will put the link of his channel in the description of this video. If you're not a subscriber from my channel, please subscribe and share this video with your friends. And also, if you liked this video, please give me a thumbs up, that helps a lot the channel. Well, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I see you later.
Oh, you don't deserve to have this sword!